I wasn't really sure if that's what to expect. But at that time, I wanted to do something meaningful, you know, spiritual, and to contribute to my community. So it was like, you know, hitting a special place.
So for you guys to bring, you know, all these different influences, and I know you sing in all the different languages. I mean, do you feel like, you know, we can make a difference in this world and with this conflict through bringing together artists like yourselves?
I think we do make a difference, even if it's something small, like, you know, touching someone from the crowd, or, you know, or making someone believe that, you know, maybe, you know, I think it can happen, and you know, coexistence can really happen.
Right. So, and also, you know, for you, and you see, like, there really aren't, even though culturally there are differences, but you have a monastery here in Jaffa, I mean, you have everyone, it's like a microcosm of what could be, and you know, it's like everyone kind of has the same roots and influences at the end of the day, correct?
Yes, absolutely. And also, yeah, what Lubna says is absolutely right. I mean, we don't have any illusions of, you know, bringing the peace to the Middle East, but
yeah, I mean, you're not gonna take this to Netanyahu's office, but you know,
no, we wanted to try, but we do get very strong reactions after Yves' performance from people who come and say, you give us hope, or we didn't think it would be possible, and we also saw, I mean, each and every one of us in the choir experienced a huge change along the way. I mean, right. We've been together for almost 10 years.
So yeah, I mean, you yourselves have grown together, and it's so meaningful. I know you have a show in September, graded here,
yes,
in Tel Aviv, and you know, we really hope you could get, you know, get the word out in more places and really be able to, you know,
yes,
travel and take this message, especially coming from women. I mean, really, it's very,
yes,
profound and deep.
Yes. Also, I mean, in Israeli society today, as you know, women's voices are a delicate issue.
Yes.
So this is also
we've all experienced that individually.
Yes.
So it's good because we have so much to say and so much to give, right?
Right.
And we work together well.
Yes.
Thank you guys so much, and continued success. Here, we need to hear you sing really loud one day so we can hear you from right outside here while we're working.
Yeah.
How does that sound?
Right.
So a stone throws away. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Meanwhile, Palestinian and Israeli teens are in Santa Fe, New Mexico, to bring peace in the Middle East as well. Here's more on the Creativity for Peace and their mission in the U.S.
After just a few weeks of American summer camp, Lama and Eden are inseparable. A friendship that would have never blossomed back home, 11,000 kilometers away, where they find themselves on opposing sides of the Israel-Palestine conflict.
If someone put a hijab, so they can't think there is a terrorist or something bad, and it's not right. So now I know that I'm gonna change something, and if someone gonna say something wrong on the Arabs, so I'm gonna protect them.
Trying to know more about each other, like feel with each other. Like we knew a lot of things that we couldn't like imagine before, so we're now real good friends.
For the past 20 years, this ranch in the hills of New Mexico has hosted 20 Israeli and Palestinian teenagers every summer. 3 weeks of shared living, activities and memories.
Those little things we do, that trying to help and promoting peace. Yeah, it's not like math. There's no one solution that can help to everybody, but we have one thing in common, and we want peace.
Paid for through private U.S. donations, the program hopes to foster trust and break down barriers.
It'll be up to these young women to do the work, and I believe they absolutely can. It's important for them to be strong enough to be able to work for peace even under very adverse conditions, and that we want them to go out into the world and take action and make things better.
Soon they'll return home to Israel or the Palestinian territories, and will have to try to hold on to the lessons they've learned here, despite being surrounded by a conflict that's lasted almost 70 years.
All right.